Are we live? I legitimately can't tell. Are we live? I legitimately
Okay,
can't
I can hear myself. That's progress. What is even happening tonight? Okay, music exists. I don't have chat. Restore chat. Okay. Good ol' YouTube streaming. What a f you know, what a different experience. You stream for a good amount of time, you think you understand streaming. Good on YouTube to come along and just give you never know what to expect. Sometimes you go live and it just doesn't. And that's okay, that's fun. All right, that's sent back out. Get me out of this mess. Okay, I think we're back in business. Also, this stream definitely popped an error before it actually went live, so I don't even know if this works either. We are the exact definition of flying blind right now. Worst case, I'll just do this over recording and upload it instead. Checking my channel in incognito mode, and I do not see a stream. I don't know if that's just a channel it. Okay, no, it says live. Now it's fine. Okay, this is like straight up. This is like some duct tape stuff. This is it popped an error, and then I forced it to go anyway, and it's working, and I don't know why. The stream is hard to find it. Yeah, honestly. Me and the word, honestly. I don't know what's going on with that lately. It's happening a whole lot, even in my scripts, and that's also a problem. Yeah, this is gonna be like five. Oh god. There's so many dead stream links down. I can just clean this up after. I just don't want people to waste time. Many people use that word, yes, but I'm using it what feels like a dangerous amount. I think part of it is just when you hear yourself talking, you hear speech patterns or tics, and it starts to like get on your nerves a bit. It's like, oh god, I'm saying that way too much. I mean, like is a common one, right? Not to say that like is bad either. I know some people absolutely hate that word, but it serves a purpose. All right, anyway, hey, hi, hello, microphones. I guess we're back at square one. Yeah, we got a raid day today. Han and Chewie. I'm still. So, Geos versus this team. I feel like Geos have a pretty solid chance of sniping Chewie. The biggest failure point right now is this boy is made of paper. Extremely paper. It's not the craziest high relic Han and Chewie. They're relic five. But. It's not fun. I know I went in and did a pre airplane mode check. Chewie is about 50% team leader. I don't know which ability. He wasn't the first person to go. But yeah, I think Geos will take out Chewie, then maybe just bring in GAC and just go for both Han and Rey. I don't know if that's too greedy. It is an ult Rey. And then. This was a bit different. This is surprising. I'm pretty sure they only used GG B2 B1, so I was kind of expecting that. Maybe that. No, I think that was their. the people that they usually fought against. This team is kind of interesting. You kind of have a whole heal tank situation, stealth onto Sith Trooper. I'm not too worried about this. There's some pretty neat synergy with Sith Trooper ignoring protection with this AoE. You have Dooku lead, so you kind of get like an AoE tenacity down, AoE heal block, or healing immunity, but... Did you miss the Gaara action? Show the game, goddammit. I just wanted to do a normal stream tonight. Yeah. Holo for the fourth time. Like, everything is just lining up so backwards. I love YouTube. I love YouTube streaming. I also, like, did a bunch of work to try to add stuff to the music playlist, and pretty much all of it got bumped with, like, most stuff just gets copyright claims. This was, like, actual, like, takedown copyright strike, like, the entire video cannot be shown, which is also extremely fun. Okay. The B2 has crit avoidance. We have Jedi. I was expecting B2, B1, but either way, this will be less crit avoidance than we're used to. I still think it'll take a little bit to kill, just because we have less crit chance as well. So we're like, let's call it minus 15% crit chance, I think, from standard, and they are minus 50% crit avoidance from standard. But we can probably just fish out B2. If we do... we've been bringing Jolie this whole time. I don't think Jolie's ever actually been needed, is a crazy part to me. If we do Hermit Yoda, we get to fish B2 immediately into Mark. If we bring Jolie, then we gotta swap. I think I'm okay with swapping. I really hate swap openers, but I think I'm okay with it. Watch him just sleep this entire time. Maybe we're not gonna get bust this spread. We could just cycle Foresight first. What a guy. He still didn't reveal! Are you kidding me? Yeah, now you're good. We're cool. Yes. Yeah, right for Grievous to be ready to one-shot. Yeah, perfect. I love it. Good, wholesome gameplay. I don't even know if this is actually a one-shot. I kind of want to tap him to make sure, because if he doesn't, that's two AoEs, and that's a bad place to be. How many hits? With a 40% chance to wake up, B2's just like, nah, man. Let's get some protection first. Yeah, Mole Eldum. So basically, the first couple times that I did Rey on stream, so what you're supposed to do is you preload, you get her down to here, and you're just throwing gear 1, level 1 in, just so that they're blowing moves, they're blowing cooldowns, Rey can't start off using Lifeblood immediately, she'll just use basic. But it's not exactly the best stream content, let's say, so I've just been doing it pre-stream now just to try to help the pacing a little bit. Like, this is as close to ideal as I think this lineup will get for a Geo run. Unfortunately, with the nature of timeouts and all that setup stuff, it is still... like, there might still be some downtime, but... let's see... banner efficiency here wasn't the best. I do respect this lineup a lot, I will say. I think if you... if I do them too poorly, it can go real sideways real quick. Ideally... Punk Unique does take a hit in 3v3. This is mostly just about who we don't want to spend. We can JTR the Bossk. Kind of wanted to JTR the crew, honestly. The Bossk isn't... see, there's another honestly. I'm telling you. It's not a thing until you realize it's a thing, and then it's all you ever hear. We do have the boys. I have grown an increasing enjoyment of the boys, and also Double Drops Day, we have an addition. This is probably about where I'm going to leave it, and I'm just going to go back to hoarding, but feeling good about this. Ideally, I'd like to get Hux to 7-star and then give him the right side pieces for best speed investment, let's call it. But yeah, I'm happy. I have a first order team now. They went from absolute budget to pretty usable in what feels like 4 or 5 weeks. And another error code. All right. First order is more dangerous, hypothetically. Their speeds are 230-ish there. It's about standard. 260... 270. 270 is a bit worrying. We're not going to do JTR. 264 with no speed lead. We don't have CLS. I'm just going to JTR this. We'll get some pretty good feet progress here with 3PO as well. Alright, non-Zeta crew. Let's wiggle for offense down. We don't have an actual... You know what, halt is halt. I'm not going to mess around with that. If he gets a good halt on JTR and she doesn't self-cleanse it, things get a lot sloppier. Alright, we get the... self-cycle with Rey. She should be back to full. Yeah. We got full cooldowns. We can just give ourselves triple translation again. Got the TM block on Fox. He's on lockdown. He's in pretty bad shape. We kind of want to weave in the 3PO basics because the 3PO basics is the feed progress. We don't have tenacity down on crew yet. I wouldn't mind getting that. We do need healing immunity on crew before we're going to make any actual progress on him, of course. Let's see. Foresight. We're pretty sighted up. We don't actually have... We don't have healing immunity on Uji Kylo anymore. This is closing out a little bit faster than I'd like. We're gonna heal him a little bit by doing this, but I think that's okay. Good damage. Good job, JTR. You're helping. We didn't have ID popped. I don't know where that came from. Use the triumvirate. Oh, so is it? The five exposes don't matter here. I'm a little bit worried that she might kill anyway. So it's just per person that was... Oh, Scion. True. Yeah, she took it. I think BB-8 got grace period, though. We got 2 protection credit. I'm curious. If it's per person doing it... Oh, wow. Yeah, it already counted. Okay, so I think it was... Because 3PO had triple translation on 3 people, then I guess each 3PO basic gave us credit for 3... Wait, no, BB-8 with ID actually should count, I think. Because I don't think we did 10 total 3PO basics there. I think... Yeah, it has to be Secret Intel, Counting Down, Illuminated Destiny. Oh, that feat is... When I read it at first, like, all I was thinking was First Order characters are, like, the self-reducers, but... Yeah, Scion, that's really not that bad when you put some more thought into it. JTR lead when you use specials. Yeah, it's true. Okay, let's... I want to say let's continue poking, but I am almost feeling like we should just poke at JCR now with the geos. Let's get an initial assessment on how this goes. The joy of BlueStacks continuing to be that we cannot do airplane mode. So we're just gonna put the mouse over the X button and yeah, hopefully Han doesn't make GeoSoldier disappear. GBA is actually kind of an annoying stun here. It did lifeblood on Han, that was planned. Okay, let's see. We double assist call here, we need to get some good tenacity down procs. GBA not going here actually doesn't matter that much, since Brute has solid base speed. Yeah, I think Chewie dies here easily. Spy gets to 100%. Spy erases Chewie from existence. Yeah, I don't know. My stocks in Han Chewie might be going down with this approach. This doesn't feel like the best. I mean, it's we took out one. We might as well just get some damage on Han. He's so lifeblooded up, though, that I would be surprised if Spy even gets any amount of headway here. Let's just heal. I don't think Rey actually has Whirlwind yet either, which is fortunate. Alright, Spy, you have three buffs to dispel, some tenacity stacking. Why was that so low? That was 10k. I mean, lifeblood, yes, but also... Chewie didn't dispel, so our stealth count hadn't reset stacks. Oh, but the self-cycle. We actually lost a lot of stealth there. Fair enough. I don't think we have a necessarily good timeout here anyway, so we might as well just play it out. We'll see if maybe... If we basic, we might get Spy going before Han, but I don't think so. Let's just... Double call, it's technically more protection and also more spy stacks. We're probably dead. Yeah. Okay. The question to me is, do we go big now or do we baby steps? Let's, I think we go with, see, this is why I should have held Gar until now. I think we poke in with two. Han plus one. Let's try to get Rey in a more cooperative state. 1x? Nah, the 1x doesn't really matter. Or you just mean for, you want to see the big boons. Yeah. With Chewie gone, we can get a better Rey preload. I don't hate that. Yeah, this is so good. This is two, maybe even three turns of Rey basics. I kind of just want to take gas right now. If Han gets damage immunity, then taking gas is a misplay. If not, then you can say, sky's the limit. I think Rex might be a bad draft here. Which sucks because this kind of, like, this is what I'm immediately leaning towards. Just fives, Archtrooper turret. If we're going for the kill on both, this feels like the best offensive pressure. Right, like, this fight is not going until Rex can nuke Han. So, the only problem is, Shock T Echo Rex isn't the worst team, but Shock with Arc is so sick. But if this fight works, then we're not going to need to worry about Shock's team strength anyway, so... We'll get some bonus turn meter with fives. The only problem that I'm seeing with Rex is this speed is very slow. I think Rey laps us twice. You know what? I think I just changed my mind. I think that immediately talked me out of it. Not to say that Rex is crazy fast, but Rex is at least going to give us that good juice we need. Okay. Please no damage immunity. We're basically just looking for days here. Days on Han. Or we can, yeah, you know, I'm just gonna give up on trying to predict. Yeah, yeah, sure, just kill her right now. Yeah, just counter, yeah. With this race state, I still don't think she has whirlwinds. I don't know what happens now. Just give her speed, I guess? Terminator to try to get gas back up faster? Yeah, just, yeah. Take that. Okay, she's gonna heal. I think we get gas standing back up again. This is getting her really, really close to ult, though. Ideally, we don't want her to whirlwind until after gas is standing back up, which... Oh god, this is gonna be so close. I don't know the order of operations on the stand-up here. Okay, Fives is dead. Damage Muse out of the way. Please, Days. Nope. Nuke isn't really doing anything here. I kind of just want to... Okay. Ult is going to eat this. This is okay. This is going to go down to Gas Last Stand versus Rey. We might as well just... Her using Whirlwind here is sick. Oh, this reduction just gave her another Whirlwind. Yep. All right. I think this is the healthiest raid that we've had so far. Yeah, it was so chaotic. It's really, really hard to try to control that. It at least goes a lot cleaner in your head at first. We could... Honestly, I almost kind of wonder if we didn't have, or if we brought Thrawn, I don't think we get counterattacks, and the counterattacks really kind of bought a lot of space at the start there. It at least got a free Han kill. The Troublemakers aren't going to bring that much damage. Stickray's not going to close it out. This would be the hardest assignment we've given the cleanup crew so far. I know that they've done it every other time, but... I don't know. This is... She's got a good amount of health pool at the start, and if she gets damage immediately, then, like, we... You know... Let's... Not to be boring, I mean, we're not gonna have to time out, so it's not gonna take that long. Let's... play responsibly here. We don't need to give the... cleanup crew any more on their plate than they need. I think she's gonna do one basic... See, this is going to be really, really hard to line up, though. If the basic... I think the order of operations is the... If she kills with the basic when she's at 25%, I don't think she gets the heal. Heal, basic... Please stay. She's getting a little bit of more free protection off of this, but it's less time... Or it's a less impending whirlwind, so I think this feels okay. All right. For your assignment. Please don't screw this up. We did turret pass to ARC Trooper. ARC Trooper gave turret to Echo. It played pretty well from there. I noticed that she's pressuring Shakti a lot, so we'll see how this goes. I definitely think we need to hold on to heal for Shakti just in case. Yeah, she just immediately goes for it. You jerk. We're also, like, right on the brink of... Ah, I hate this. This is so... That's a lot of protection to work through as well. That's a green bar. That is not what you want to see. This might just be worth backing out. There is absolutely 0% chance of this working now. I don't understand, like, we fought against offense raids before, and this feels like she is actually lifestealing more. Might just feel like it because she has more health, but it's not percent based, so that wouldn't really make sense logic-wise. And she does have CD. Speed X1? Nah, it's... It doesn't really help here. It's just, there's no reason to play it out, right? We're gonna kick her down to damage immunity. She doesn't technically get a whirlwind yet, but she's gonna kick up to 100% on our next turn, and then she's gonna get a whirlwind. The clones cannot do this much damage. They were the closing team for when she had like 25% health. That's unfortunate. Maybe, I mean, Gas did get a Daze chance. I wonder if we should have just brought in Gas as the closer instead and just harassed down Han. The problem is at this point we're going to start throwing stuff at the wall that we might need for other teams. So I think, yeah, we got the status update on Rey. Now we just need to clear everything else and then we come back with what we have left. Sounds like a reasonable position to me. I think that Resistance Hero Bros could actually handle Bosk fairly well as long as Poe doesn't get resisted. This doesn't sound bad to me. Yeah, we'll have Bosk control. Pretty solid damage. Their protection ratio is high, so their percent HP isn't going to be doing a whole lot of heavy lifting, but sounds right to me. We have potency on Poe as well. I think he got this. Okay. I think in this case, I think Poe's going before Bosk anyway. Let's just, yeah, he is not even on the map. I don't know if we need to grenade. Probably gonna take a little bit to get through Bosk. Let's just I said some words. It feels like any time that I say something like that now, it's just the, like, it's not even like a couple of seconds to get there. It's just the game's like immediately like, no, wrong. Stop talking. Like, I didn't even finish that sentence and Bosk is just like, pop. Immediately dead. Talon Asajj. I actually don't see this that much. Okay. Max possible. Well, you can't use 105 because it's 3v3. Spirit's pretty slow. Padme against this would be pretty comfy, and I don't think Padme against Rey is going to accomplish a whole lot. Is that true? If we draft healing immunity, we could at least, like, if she gets into damage immunity, it'll at least buy some time, but, like, the damage is just so bad, I really don't see the matchup working. Ooh. I wonder if we could get away with Kylo Watt Fox here. I know I said that the Shock T team was a tall ask. This feels worse. This is a bit scary. Yeah, Anakin's Guild Lock is dispellable. Yeah, I'm not sure, we could, I know the boys are my shiny new toy, but I don't know, man. One whirlwind. He's not eating that. I don't care what you think. I mean, Fox has the damage, but we have Thrawn still. That means something. Maybe First Order, Thrawn. It feels like First Order, like, it feels like Fox is the only real damage we have left. Like, Fox or Stick Ray, we could just try, like, Thrawn lead Fox Stick Ray. Thrawn's gonna be a must, yeah. Actually, that does remind me. It might be worth... I think we need to start dipping into potency secondaries on GAC. Because Rey has, like, 100% base tenacity. Yeah. So she was getting some extra help as well. Yeah, I think we're gonna have to take a look at that. Yeah, fair enough. Thrawn Fox Stick Rey, for whatever reason in my head, doesn't sound suicidal. I feel like it should. I don't think Fracture is going to last that long is the problem. Also, this extra protection isn't doing us many favors. Maybe sure for some crit immunity. If you say so. I don't know, man. I think he gets, like, 2 seconds. I'm actually, ironically, Geos are so perfectly suited for taking out Chewie there that I don't regret using them, but I think Geos would have been the best suited for trying to take this on. Thrawn the Fox Stick, yeah. We just got a third damage at the wall. Yeah, let's take out the rest. But if we do Thrawn Fox Stick, then we're square one on the RH Bros. I'm assuming they're pretty good speed as well. 303. Okay. For doing Thrawn Fox Stick. It's... Oh no, it's Real Bossk, that's right. That's such a big ask though, I don't know. And also the AoE counterattacks, I really don't see this as... being smart? Generally advisable? Stacking Finn damage, this is a long burn strategy. Scion's gonna get eaten up. Padme, we could just Padme. I think we can get a bit fancier with this than this. And I don't think Poe Unique isn't gonna bomb a Padme team the way it does in 5v5. Famous last words, I think this is the best choice. I think this is the most respect worth giving. We can, Traverse Night Sisters can go sideways, but I think we can play more from there. Oh, they don't have Zombie either, so they don't have Tenacity down for Scion. Might be worth thinking about. We could do, like, Hermit Yoda Scion, even. We got options. Alright. This doesn't feel great. This isn't my first choice, but this feels like the best. Oh, that was the hard part. Okay. We have GK taunting. We have courage. I kind of just... Poe is the hurt here. That's not dissing on Finn at all, but I would really enjoy it if we could stop getting nuked this hard. Didn't die. It's gonna be a 50-50 on if this Mass Assist call calls Padme. I think we have to go for this, because otherwise Padme is unprotected. When's Anakin? Whew. Alright. Finn counterattack, you're not gonna crit. What do you even do? Yeah, get out of here. fight continues to be extremely uncomfortable. Okay. Progress. I still really would just like you dead. It's coming. I can feel it. Any day now. I don't even know if she's grace period for 100% health. I don't even care. Get me out of here. That was almost as bad as trying to do Jedi Knight Revan with Anakin versus Padme lead. It's just, I'm not in control here. I'm just along for the ride. We got Bastila lead. We got toys. We got EP. We got Treyan. I don't know if Bastila lead is the most responsible thing to bring here. Do we even have real Jedi left? Ish. Extremely ish. And they're not going to deal with Snowtrooper or this at all. It's about 100% potency. They're not, like, we're not going to have to deal with Zombie or Daka at all. So while there is some amount of stunlock potential here, I actually feel like this could work. Another brutal, messy battle, but given what we have left. Crew against Dooku sounds kind of interesting, actually. Wait. 100% potency on Talzin. Oh, she has potency too, man. I was about to say, there's no tenacity down here. We could mess this. I think. Okay, that's. Look, you need to calm down a little bit. With Talzin lead, especially. Yeah, it's. I was like 85% of the way to greenlighting this there. Until that spirit showed up. You need to call down a little bit, buddy. That's dangerous. Spirit will never stun. Flare boot. I want to remind you, there is plus 50% potency here on Mother Talzin lead. With. She only. Oh. Yeah, but it's going to use the dispel. It's going to think that Master's Training is dispellable, right? So it's going to try. Same reason, like, it'll try to do it on Foresight, correct? Like, that's why Bastila Zeta feels pretty safe. How did it go versus Rey? Clean Geos against Chewie, clean gas kill on Han, but I'm wondering if that wasn't a mistake to use gas. I think we should have just chipped at Han and then closed with gas because the extra Rey finished with some extra protection preloading her down to this, and it was too much for the clones to actually get through. She just healed above 50% before they could bring her back down. Nest here feels dangerous. Consider option B, which. His lead doesn't give him potency. He has potency. Said this is almost up. Yeah. I wonder if we could have done Nest again. Dude, this... No, I'm not even going to finish that sentence. The damage here was low enough. Nest actually maybe could have done this. I think we can do a Nest support comp. Let's put it that way. You know what? I'm going in. I need to know. I need to get this off of my head first, and then I can just do the rest. He's not Relic 7, but he's gotta wear accounts. I actually don't even think he has to wear accounts, to be honest. Yeah, he's... Look, he's a work in progress. We all are. He's also... One... Fuck. Throne Fracture is gonna end, and he isn't even going to have gone yet. Look. Is this anything? She's fast. Her mods aren't... Her mods are even worse. But she's fast, okay? Why not try Nest next when this fails? In a 1v1 scenario... Ness is just never gonna have purple shield, so she's just even ignoring Whirlwind. Like, if you had five people beating up on Ness, then I would say, yeah, you could try to set things up so that Ness can't get Whirlwinded as easily with a huge amount of purple protection. But in this case, yeah, it's optimistic. Yeah, I've been getting in tune with Nest limitations lately. I don't know. I kind of just lost all faith in Fox when I remembered how slow he was and how much support he wouldn't have with Thrawn and Stick. The boy would get like one chop off at best. Okay, what if... What if we just go for it? Like, what if we just... Like, it's not the best option. But it's the one we have. It's a 50-50 on who gets Whirlwind into. Stick Rain might be able to... Stick around, goddammit. I apologize for even saying that. Conditional is 55% coin flip for a third damage. I love it. She will. I mean, maybe. This might be the way. This might be the way we have to do it. Okay. Stick Ray, she has been increasingly earning her stripes on this stream lately. I still feel like this is way too much to ask for. But if there was ever a time to bail me out of my bad choices. You like Thrawn instead of Bastila? I don't know, I feel like we're just setting up for one big nuke at the start and seeing if that buys us any time. And also, my biggest concern with Thrawn is... I feel like Fracture isn't going to actually last that long. Like minus 50% speed. Raid doesn't even... Our stick raid doesn't even lap him twice there. I don't know that actually changes much. Also, their Ray is going to be immune to TM removal. I think Thrawn buys us a bit of time? Wait, isn't this redundant? Oh. Raid boss condition. This is Jedi only, I'm pretty sure. Okay. I think she might have higher priority targeting on Thrawn as well, so this actually might work out. It definitely felt like the Resistance Heroes did. As I recall from my early practice testing. Alright, this might earn it. It still feels like less damage overall, but she'll at least have Master's Training. Flare Boot says wait. I also like Vassila for the... I'm doing Hermiota over Vassila. I mean, I guess you could argue that the stealth is a negative. Offense up these Master's Training. It's the same. It's 50%. Except Master's Training can't be dispelled. I was about to say... Vassila basic at least buys us some space, but if we're in a situation where this starts to matter, then we're, like, on the fast track to... Oh, true. Well, then I'm just back to here. I don't know. I have mixed feelings on Thrawn. Let's put it that way. And I'm pretty sure that she's going to lifesteal before he takes a turn, because she should be... Wait. I think she's going to lap Thrawn twice as a problem, so I think she gets to the green. She's not going to debuff Thrawn, so there's no real point running Thrawn lead, I don't think. I don't know. In my mind's eye, the idea of giving her Master's Training plus Vassila buff sounds like the best chance of actually going for it, but let's try this. She has a green, you're never winning. Yep, that's the idea. That's honestly why I like Thrawn, or why I like Hermiota more than Thrawn. It feels like we're just going for a burst of damage at the start to get her low enough that we buy some time. I don't think Fracture gets us there as much. That's why I feel so uncomfortable about this, honestly. Like with Hermiota, we get another assist. We get 25% more damage. Yoda is... Well... Oh. Yeah, Hermit Yoda is fast and gets TM with Vassila. Is my thought process. Flavor, I don't think she doesn't lifesteal back to green in one basic here. She does it in two. But I'm pretty sure her 2 meter is set pretty high. I think it has to be 0%, right? But it's going to be 320 plus 15% from Vassila lead. Okay, we'll get speed up on Stick Ray. She has to be 0%, right? Because she was the one who finished it. 579. So she can't lap Thrawn twice, but the moment that Fracture ends, she's pretty much going. Okay, let's try Thrawn. We can talk in circles about this all day. I think both arguments sound very compelling to me, which is part of why this is such a hard choice to make. Like, if you hit her with a higher burst, then it's essentially... a mini Fracture, because you've guaranteed that Rey's next turns, A, she can get into damage immunity, B, she can't, Whirlwind you. You just guarantee a series of basics that you can try to out DPS. But then again, after Hermiota's first turn, he isn't actually that high value. At least not for a bit. Alright, this is probably the last Rey attempt, I think. I don't think we can build a reasonable team beyond this. Okay, as advertised. No Not a lot. Let's try to get... Ability block doesn't actually matter that much here. She's just going to use basic anyway. I think this is technically more damage. Last chance. No crit chance buff either. Oh my fucking god, dude. Yeah, she's in the green. Good shit. That's disappointing. That's very disappointing. And the most disappointing aspect of it is if you whiff the first part, then the triple hit doesn't even get to try. Alright, fuck you. I'm just... straight into ults. And we might as well back out to preserve it in case we get some bright idea in. I do think Thrawn probably felt better there overall. And definitely, I would say... like, you could still call that confirmation bias, like, this was a small sample size, but I'm pretty sure Thrawn has higher coded priority. The Risen Heroes, Rey, like, in every case that Thrawn was there, they have always gunned for him immediately when he was targetable. It was close. If we had something like a... yeah, she ended up getting a decent amount of turns outside of Fracture. The thing that sold me was she would have speed up, Thrawn would have minus 50% speed, so there was actually enough room generated that I think was more value. Alright, well, in a way, I feel like I kind of tutorialized how they could beat me, but... let's wrap things up, I guess. Do what we can. We saw how close Rey was to ult, so I don't even know if I could say for sure. Yeah, UA Cole, that's... I feel like we wouldn't have killed her there anyway. But actually, you know what would have been a clutch choice? Is if we landed that, I think we could just time it out there. You can play from there very, very easily. Actually, that would have been really sick, too. You know what? I'm glad we did this. This was good science. Stick Rey, I might actually just give her better mod budget for the coming week. With Rey in that healthier position, I feel like Stick Rey could have softened Rey up pretty heavily for a Shock T League cleanup. Oh. Well, I guess the good news is... the boys... this could get a little bit weird with Dooku being Dooku. It's Dooku lead, he's gonna put healing immunity on Kylo, that's awkward. We'll have Watt able to cleanse Kylo, that's less awkward. Dooku can potentially cross stun. I feel like Watt's gonna have to do some heavy lifting here. Yeah. Let's do this. It's actually a really fortunate counter and attack timing, but it actually doesn't really matter that much. He's just gonna pop into stealth before we could do anything. Alright, let's just start stacking Fox. Let's just immediately kill said trooper, you know. I seriously just have no idea how to gauge their damage at this point. Just... I'm so used to Fox just being like, alright, we'll spend about 2 minutes, you know, keep burning your cooldowns. We'll get you to a point where you can hurt people. Yeah, just one shot Dooku. Okay. We trusted him a little bit too much there, but we're close. There's no point halting. What do you have? Oh, it's a Dooku lead. Why is this motherfucker counterattacking me? Who do you think you are? I like it. It's like a sassy B1. He's tired of your shit. I think next crew turn is going to have to be halt. We want Watt to cycle if we can. Halt, Fox please go, Fox is full, should be full banners. Nice. This team is just fun to drive. I really wish we were playing 5v5. Like, the fact that I haven't actually gotten to use them yet. Like, Rey, I'm fine with having, and theory crafting her has been fun, but, like, Frizzler is just fun to play. I haven't even tried this dude yet. Like, it's been almost 24 hours. I haven't even, like, stuck anything on him. Okay. This is a little bit clunky. There's a lot of plague, there's a lot of stuns. I'm leaning towards Treya, it's not gonna be great banners. That's for science? Look. It lost another fight because we tried something we shouldn't have. Wait, okay. It's time. The forbidden technique. Where even is he? We saved him, he's here. Master, forgive me. I think I believe here. We just need to get Master's training down. Okay, yeah, see? Easy. Actually, if we can end this now, we might be able to keep Hermit Yoda alive. It's a big ask. Oh, he deflected. Oh, he deflected the books. Kill. You're just kind of hanging out. Okay. He's just unstealth, like, you done? Sure. Yeah, that's a respectable plus 60% tenacity there. That was more than making up for a Talzin lead. Oh, that's true. I wasn't even looking for the cooldown. I still think my counter-argument, my rationale, not knowing, right, because message training is coded as a buff. And I don't think the AI is smart enough to know that it's undispellable. So yeah, it is kind of interesting that they didn't use it. Well, that's... I mean, okay, look, that's like a 3v3 thing only, and also only if Zombie isn't there. But, yeah, there are some situations. I think Mandalorian lead, I think, can be clutch. Generally, they don't try to dispel undispellable. I feel like, I mean, it might be different between buffs and debuffs, but, like, I'm pretty sure... You know, if JTR puts healing immunity on someone, I'm pretty sure the AI does try to cleanse it off. That could just be an ability priority thing, like they were going to use it anyway, but... I definitely had that in my head. I think... We do have the slightly updated droids this week. I think we could just go with this. Sure, let's try this. It's gonna be RNG if we can get the spy taunt on Falcon, but if we can, he should fall very quickly. That, or we're just gonna get absolutely shredded by rebels. You know, the new Y-wing for not. I don't think he's bad. I think he's just a little bit tragic. Like they, I think they should have made his protection dispel missile unresistible. I mean, we don't have crowd control in this case. If we don't do the first special, we don't get overcharge, but I've kind of been liking playing with just holding it. Let's just do it. Overcharge is sick. Why stop now? Falcon does a buzz droid, kind of unfortunate. Didn't dodge that one then. One, he's just dodging everything. I mean, he's got like, what? Plus 25 or something evasion? I love this team. Yeah, try dodging everything. You might have decent evasion rate, but you're no GL Ray. I mean, we used First Order. If we had like GBA or something. There's really any meaningful damage that we could throw at her left. Droidico wouldn't be able to stack anyway, even if mine was good. It's unfortunate about stick. Good ol' 2% dodge rate. She was channeling JTR's stacking evasion relic that whole time. Alright, well, I think we're tapped. I don't think we get through this. My team is the same. I think I'm a little bit like, I have some more relics. I'd like to think more imposing mods, but the general step process for Rey Hunt, we feel, is pretty consistent. Hold up, the stick Rey. Like, we had Rey down to here. Stick Rey went for the nuke. I don't think it kills her, but it would have been a very, very, very different situation to play from there. Alright, later, Flare Boot. I'll just call it here. Hey. Oh, well. That was just... Sorry, fun. I'm just a little bit tilted. Like, not really, but... There was a lot of build-up for what ended up losing to a 2% evasion chance. Alright, well... Good luck to Peggy. I've got some stuff on defense. It's not a walkover, but we'll see... how they handle it, I guess. I'm still not decided on this team. Theoretically, it could tax you pretty hard on protection banners. Or they could just, like, throw a JTR at you and just not even think about it. Yeah, we'll see. Alright, thanks for watching, everyone. Peace out.